Hello, this is Bern, and if you've ever found yourself not feeling attracted to commitment-minded men, good men, but for some reason feeling super attracted to guys who are non-committal, who are avoidant, who are not that much into you, and you can't seem to figure out what's going on, well, on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you three core reasons why this happens and why you want to take a hard look at how your blueprint for love is set up right now. Stick around. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great life TV.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. And on today's episode, I'm gonna be sharing with you three core reasons why lots of women don't feel a deep level of attraction towards commitment-minded, quality, awesome guys, and seem to feel somehow incredibly attracted to guys who are not good for them, who are non-committal, who are avoidant in many ways, and can't figure out a way to change this. So here's the first baseline I want to establish. I'm not referring to good men who are boring, or a good man who want to make love with their socks on because it's kind of cold, or a good man who are wimpy and not strong or masculine. There's an obvious reason why you would not be attracted to a strong man who is kind of weak, or a mama's boy, or someone who is not strong in his level of desire or his level of stepping up for himself. I completely get that. I'm not referring to those kinds of men. I have connected with enough women in this world who, time and time again, given the natural choice, would go for the guy who's bad for them versus the guy who's good for them. And I'm going to tell you right now that there's three fundamental reasons, there's more than three, but there's three I'm going to talk about today, why this happens. Okay, the first reason is because when you connect to a guy who's showing up really strong, who wants commitment the way you want commitment, who's more into you at the beginning that you're even used to, because what you're used to is guys who are just like making you kind of like beg for love, and he's actually showing you an overflowing level of desire to connect with you, not pushy, but at the same time, very committed to making things happen. There's a short circuit in your brain that makes you feel uneasy, because why is he doing it? Like, is there a secondary thing that he wants from me? Like, but the first thing, the first reason why a lot of women don't feel a level of attraction towards him, it's not a conscious one, it's subconsciously, because for him to continue connecting with you means that he's going to see all of you. He's going to see you naked, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Because he wants that. He wants to see more of you. And if you're inside thinking, well, shit, he's going to discover me for the fraud that I am, not consciously, but subconsciously, he's going to see all my shit, all my unresolved things, then guess what's going to happen? If I'm not attracted to him, I don't go deep with him, he never has to see me. So it's not a conscious thing, but subconsciously, you're creating a lack of attraction to him because that prevents you from opening your heart and soul and being seen completely. So that's the first reason why a lot of women don't feel that level of strong connection. Because here's the thing, the dude who just wants to fuck you, quote unquote, he doesn't want to go deep, so he never has to discover all parts of you. You don't have that vulnerability of sharing your heart and soul to him. Second reason why women many times don't feel a strong level of attraction towards guys who are good, who are also masculine, who are also good looking, is because there's another fear that takes place in your heart, which is, well, shit, can I sustain this? Well, if this thing is good and it starts happening and now I'm getting used to it, what if I can't keep up? What if I have to continue showing up awesomely? What if I have to stop doing the things I used to do in the past that got me into trouble? What if it's gonna be a lot of work for me to actually sustain this great relationship that I've been desiring since I have use of reason? But what if it's too hard? So guess what happens? If I don't feel this guy is attractive, then I don't have to continue doing, because it's way harder to sustain a relationship that's awesome than it is to enter and exit relationships every 2 or 3 months, right? Second reason. Third reason is, and this is a big one, because what happens if you now find the kind of love you didn't even know existed? You feel it deeply in your heart. You feel it, it's like complete overwhelming love, sensations, feelings, emotions, spirit, friendship, and then you lose it. Well, if you lose that kind of love, my dear, you might be out of it. You might be depressed for the next 2 years. It's the difference between falling of a 100th story building versus a three-story building, which is the kind of thing you've been doing over the last 10 relationships where you lose the guy and it feels painful, but from the start there were 10 warning signs that told you in the back of your mind it's never gonna happen, so it's ended before it's even started, so it's painful, but it's not as painful as something that truly has the potential to create that kind of passionate, conscious relationship you've always wanted. So here there are three reasons why it might be benefiting you subconsciously to not feel attraction towards him, because if you did feel attraction towards him, you would go from a second-class problem to a first-class problem, which is harder to solve, more vulnerable in nature, and more difficult to overcome once you get started. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful. If you want to find out more ways to break out of this cycle of shit, basically, if you want to find more ways to co-create the kind of relationship you want and create the kind of desire towards men that are good for you, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on this video or thumbs up. Number two, subscribe to my channel, hit the subscribe button. Number three, on the first line of the description of this video, you're gonna find a link that allows you to start watching a free masterclass I created for you to show you how to create the kind of relationship you want, how to connect to the type of man you want in a lot less time with a lot less pain than your current or past trajectory. All you do is click on that first line of the description of this video. It's gonna take you to a page where you'll see a little video, just quick one, a yellow bar, click on the yellow bar, enter your name and email, and you'll be set and start watching this. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.